Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Ashley, can you turn me down?
Dad, who do you love the most? Toddlers have a curious mind. They ask questions, lots of them. Some are silly. Others show the depths of their growing minds. Dad, who is your favorite? Who do you love the most? As my family grows, so does the number of times that question gets asked. They want to know if Mom and Dad have enough love to go around. Now, to be sure, Becca and I assure our kids that we love them each deeply and intensely. But we do let them know that we're open to bribes for the title of favorite child. The colors and sounds of our love may vary from child to child, but it remains equally deep for each one of them. Who do you love the most? Let me pose that question to you. Who do you love the most? The Father, the Son, or the Holy Spirit? Who do you like best? Or even more challenging, who is the most important person of the Trinity? The Father, the Son, or the Holy Spirit? Now, some of you heard me ask this question before, but it's a curious little thought experiment. Of course, there is no one more important person of the Trinity. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are miraculously and mysteriously three distinct and co-equal persons of the one true God. However, if it were possible, which it is not, but if it were possible, who do you think it would be? Would it be God the Father? After all, He created us and loved us so much that He sent His Son Jesus to be our Savior. But then, what about Jesus? He was the one who suffered in your place and mine, died for your sins, for mine, and then rose to life to give you hope and eternal life. Or what about that little known and little remembered Holy Spirit? Just what exactly does He do anyway? Well, today is Pentecost, the celebration of the Holy Spirit coming upon the disciples. So you might guess where I'm going with this. I contend that if it were possible, which it is not, but if it were possible, the Holy Spirit might just be the most important. And why? Well, without the Holy Spirit, you and I would never be able to believe in Jesus Christ. We'd never be able to trust God the Father, who loves us so much that sent us Jesus to be our Savior. Now, Jesus Himself testifies to the work of the Holy Spirit. Chapter 15 of John, verse 26. Listen again. But when the Helper comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, He will bear witness about me. Now, this verse is packed with precision and it's saturated with salvation. The Holy Spirit is identified as the Helper. Now, you and I both love helpers. Good help is often tough to find. Do you know who really loves to help? Toddlers. They love to help with things like baking, the dishes, or even the laundry. It's very often really a mixture of all three at one time. And usually when you're not looking. After all, surprise help is always the best kind of help, right? Perhaps you know this kind of help, where your toddler or your grandchild diligently pushes her chair up to the counter, then carefully stirs all the ingredients together in the mixing bowl, adding an extra cup of flour and an egg, shell and all for good measure, and then proceeds to masterfully pour all those ingredients into the cake pan, under the counter, her pants, the silverware drawer, and then the floor. And of course, wanting to be thoughtful, she then proceeds to use your best dish towels along with her shirt and socks to wipe up the mess where she accidentally spilled. And voila, your toddler has helped with the baking, the dishes, and the laundry all in one fell swoop. Now perhaps that's not quite the helper that Jesus meant. The Holy Spirit is called the helper because he helps you through the mess that we call life. He is the one who works faith in you by the power of the gospel. He's no ordinary being, after all. He's God the Holy Spirit. He proceeds from the Father and from all eternity, is sent into time, into this world, and into your hearts by water and word of holy baptism. And Jesus is clear about the Holy Spirit. He's the Spirit of truth who testifies to Jesus. In other words, his job is simple. He shows you Jesus. He gives you Jesus and then wraps you in his love. And like a parent who deeply loves each of his children with varying colors and sounds, the Holy Spirit lavishes you with the specific care and affection that God knows you desperately need. When temptation afflicts you, he exposes the darkness of Satan's lies. When uncertainty confronts you, he encourages you with the Father's promises. When shame haunts you, his holiness covers you. When guilt afflicts you, he washes you in the forgiveness of sins. And when hearts stop beating and lungs stop breathing, he comforts you with the promise of the resurrection of the body and the life everlasting. Just to be clear, toddlers aren't the only ones who make messes in life, are they? They aren't the only ones who worry about being loved. Teenagers, of course, they bear up under all kinds of constant anxiety and the desire of approval. They try to navigate the chaos of raging hormones and the pressures to fit in. Parents who, perhaps you feel, just don't get it. Relationship messes, the length of girls' dresses, and all the peer pressure yeses make life as a teenager chaotic and neurotic. But of course, adults also certainly know what the messes of life are like. You and I long for love just the same. We know the cruelty of this fallen creation and all too often experience the frailty of our flesh. And then with that, there are the bad decisions and the betrayals of life, lost tempers and lonely times, behaviors that's selfish, and life that feels hellish. They afflict and ail adult and child alike. And so Jesus sends the Helper, God the Holy Spirit. Full of grace and truth, he comes among you not by the blowing of the wind or the swelling of your emotions or the power of your intellect, but through the very Word of God. Where the Word of God is, there the Holy Spirit is. And where this world looks to blockbuster superheroes with X-Men superpowers and Hulk-smashing strength, the Holy Spirit comes among you through the still, small voice of the gospel. He grabs your imagination and captivates your inclination with the power of God's Word. Through that very Word, he creates faith. He shapes beauty
and he forms truth. Through parables and propositions, through psalms and through sacraments, the Holy Spirit rushes among you to bring you Jesus. He comforts your heart. He heals your hurts. And he delivers life-giving hope. That's the power of the gospel. That's the Holy Spirit at work in your life. When you hear God's word, there the Holy Spirit is. He's eternally fixed to the word of truth so that you can know right from wrong, good from evil, blessing from curse. He's sent into this world, baptized into your life to help you, to love you, to guard you from the evil one. Every time that you pray the Lord's Prayer, you confess the Apostles' Creed. There the Holy Spirit is bringing you the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. He is God, the Holy Spirit, and he points you to Jesus. He gives you Jesus. He sanctifies the mess you call life, and he loves you like no other. And just in case you wanted to compare messes, let your imagination explore the almighty mess that Jesus endured for you. Betrayed by his friends, abused by the church, bragging the liar, abandoned by his disciples, his flesh was tore open while his mouth he kept shut. The cup of God's wrath was poured out on him while his friends ran out on him. Crucified, dead, and buried, he was a bloody mess. And then 3 days later, the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon him, breathed life into his lungs, put a pulse back into his heart, and he walked out of that tomb alive. And the mess of sin and death was cleansed and cleaned once for all by the Father, in the Son, through the Holy Spirit. See, there is no mess too ugly and no sin too big to stop him from loving you fully and completely. Whether graduate, grandparent, or grieving, God the Holy Spirit calls you into his holy Christian church. He brings you into the communion of saints. And here he forgives your sins and brings to you the resurrection of the body and the life everlasting.